Hi viewers, welcome to LMR Solution. Today we are going to see about how to measure total harmonics of voltage and current in MATLAB. For that I am going to use three phase . So first you have to take three phase voltage source, okay. So here I'm going to use three phase voltage source, and then next I'm going to use universal bridge. In that universal bridge I'm going to use only diode, okay. That mean I'm going to make connect a non-linear load in the three phase source, and then I'm going to measure the current and grid current and grid voltage, and then next you have to check the THD, total harmonics. We can call it as total harmonic distortions or THD. Okay, so we are going to measure that the total harmonic distortion of the grid voltage and grid current. So just I'm going to connect this three phase source in the universal bridge. So this is nothing but a three phase rectifier, and then output here, right? So here I'm going to use RLC branch. So here I'm going to take RLC branch. So this will be going to be act as a filter. Here I am not design anything, right? That means I am not design the filter. Just I am going to use whatever value as it is. That means default value we are whatever default value is in that RLC branch. So just I am going to use that one. And here I am going to select R load, right? R load is better, you can choose R load, okay. So here I am taken that R load, and in between this three phase source and the universal bridge, so I am going to use another block, nothing but the three phase measurement block. So just you go to type here measurement, and then you can see here, right, three phase voltage and current measurement. Just you go to take this one and connect directly here, and then here also you can connect, and next you have to store this voltage and current in the workspace. So for that just you have to type to workspace, so first one is voltage, so just you have to connect voltage and then make the name as VG and select a structure with time, okay. And next one is a grid current, so here I am going to make IG, and also I am going to connect scopes, that mean to see the waveform of input voltage. So here I am going to connect scope, and I'm going to use two input scope with the two layout. So one is for a grid voltage, another one is for a grid current, and then here I'm going to fix the voltage, right? Here the voltage will be 25 kilovolt and the frequency is 60 hertz, so I'm going to use same value, right? And then here I'm going to use the time value equal to 0.1. So first I'm going to simulate this model. So here we are used to that three phase voltage source and the series RLC branch. So for that we need Powergui, right? So just you go to type Powergui. So here you can see that Powergui, right? So you can place here, then only you can simulate this model. Now I'm simulating this model. So this is the result we have got from this. So because here I am not model anything, right? So here I am using the water value as it is in that default option, right? So this is the result we are getting from that grid voltage and grid current. So this is example how to measure the THD, total harmonic distortion, in the voltage and current. Okay, so after simulating this one, you can go to main window of the MATLAB. So here you can see that we can see two variables, structured variables. So one is VG, another one is IG. So this will be stored automatically in the workspace by means of this block, right? To workspace. Okay, and also you can use this scope to store the variable in the workspace. So for that, go to click that scope window, go to view and configuration properties. So here you can see that logging, right? So here you can click this one and then you can log data to workspace. So you can use this option also. So here I'm going to use log data to workspace and then with the structure with the time. Okay, so here I'm going to simulate this one. So here also you can see that, right? So it's stored as a data scope data, because in scope window, right, we mentioned that name, the name for log, right? Log data is scope data. Okay, so that's why we are seeing that data, scope data here. So now we are going to measure THD, total harmonic distortion, right? So for that, you click continuous and click tools, and here you can go to FFT analysis. So now you can see that the whatever data available in the workspace, right? So automatically it see here, right? IG, scope data, VG, right? So now it's showing that IG data. So it contain input, right? So it is having three inputs, right? A, B, C. So you can choose any one signal. Okay, now I'm going to fix the time, right? So here I'm going to fix number of cycle equal to 1, and then starting time for calculating THD equal to 0.016. okay, and then here you have to mention the 60 hertz, because source frequency is 60 hertz. So here you have to mention 60, and then you can fix maximum frequency is 2500. And then here you can see two options. One is Nyquist frequency, and then you can see CMS maximum frequency. So you can use both. Better you can use CMS maximum frequency, and then so you can see the you can change the x-axis, like in terms of frequency in harmonic order. So for initially I'm going to use frequency option for x-axis, and then I'm going to click display. So now you can see here, right? You will see the THD, total harmonic distortion, for the grid current is around 28.75%. So now I'm going to change to signal 1 and check the value. So it around 22.84. for second signal is 12.21, for third signal is 28.75%. okay, so now I'm going to change the frequency axis will be harmonic order. So here you can click this one and click display. So here you can see that the frequency will be changed to harmonic order, right? So now I am going to change this one to frequency. So here you can see that the x will be in frequency form. So when you change to harmonic order, it will be in a harmonic order form. Okay, same you can see the THD for voltage also. So just you have to change the name of the variable. Okay, and then you can select the signal and then you can click display. So you will see that THD, total harmonic distortion, in this FFT analysis tool. Okay, so next one is I'm going to choose scope data. So here I'm going to click scope data, So it have two signal, input one, input two, right? Input one nothing but voltage, so input two nothing but the current, right? So that means this scope data contains the detail of grid voltage and the grid current, okay? But when you are going to use this block, right, the signal will be stored in the different variable VGIG. When you are to use scope, that means option in the scope, right, so it will be stored in the same, then in single variable like scope data, the scope data contains the two variable detail, the voltage and grid current, okay? So here also you can see the THD, okay? So this is the way you can see the THD of the voltage and current in the MATLAB. So thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.